गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इन थर्मोडायनेमिक्स चैप्टर, दैट इज इंटरनल एनर्जी. दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय कैपिटल ई आर कैपिटल यू. कैपिटल ई आर कैपिटल यू. हियर द डेफिनेशन फॉर दैट इज द एनर्जी स्टोर्ड इन द सिस्टम इज कॉल्ड इंटरनल एनर्जी. एनर्जी स्टोर्ड इन द सिस्टम वर आर सम ऑफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी, पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, रोटेशनल एनर्जी. ऑल दीज एनर्जीज ऑल्सो कंसिडर एज internal energy. Here you have to know some points regarding internal energy, that is internal energy of a system cannot be determined. System means either solid, liquid, gas or anything or any substance we can consider as system which is under observation. So what is the point? Internal energy of a system cannot be determined, but change in internal energy, that means change in internal energy means delta E or delta U, can be determined experimentally, not theoretically, experimentally by using bomb calorimeter experiment. That means by using this experiment we can find change in internal energy. The formula for that is delta E equal to EP minus ER. EP means what? Internal energy of products. And ER means what? Internal energy of reactants. What is the definition of internal energy? Energy stored in the system. We cannot find internal energy, but change in internal energy can be found by using experiment. Next, enthalpy, that is represented by capital H. These terms are important, especially for numerical purpose. Enthalpy, it is represented by capital H. Here the definition for enthalpy is the sum of internal energy and work done. Sum of internal energy and work done is called enthalpy. From that definition we can write H equal to E plus W. Like internal energy, enthalpy of a system also cannot be determined, because H equal to E plus W, we cannot find E, automatically we cannot find H. But change in enthalpy can be determined by using delta E value. That means after finding delta E value, we can find delta H value. What is the formula? H equal to E plus W. H equal to E plus P delta V. We know that. Why? How? W equal to P delta V. From this, delta H equal to what? Delta E plus delta nRT. How? P delta V equal to nR, P V equal to nRT. P delta V equal to delta nRT. Then delta H equal to delta E plus delta nRT. Next one here, like internal energy, delta H equal to HP minus HR, nothing but enthalpy of products minus enthalpy of reactants. Next, here one more term is the delta N is what? NP minus NR. NP means number of gaseous products and number of gaseous reactants. That means we have to consider only gaseous substances. NP means number of gaseous products, NP, NR means number of gaseous reactions. NP minus NR means what? Delta N. So from this expression we can find everything. Delta H, delta E. This can be found by using bomb calorimeter. Automatically we can find this one. Next, if delta N is 0, suppose in this expression, if you put delta N is 0, then this total term will become 0, then delta H equal to delta E. If suppose delta N is greater than 0, that means if it is positive value, that means delta N is positive value, that automatically this value will be more than delta E. Nothing but delta H is greater than delta E. If suppose delta N is less than 0, delta N is less than 0, that means if delta N is negative value, then automatically this value will be less than this, nothing but delta H less than delta E. These three expressions are very, very important expressions regarding numericals. Next, you may get these type of questions in CBSE level. That is, one question will be given, you have to write relation between delta H and delta E. To find the relation between delta H and delta E, you have to know the relation, you have to know the value of delta N. What is the value of delta N? Delta N equal to NP minus NR. NP means number of gaseous products. Two gaseous products, two minus gaseous reactions, both are present in gaseous state. 1 plus 3, total 4. That means N value negative. If N is delta N is negative value, then delta H less than delta E. One more expression, 2SO3 gas, 2SO2 gas, O2 gas. One more example. In this case also all are present in gaseous state. Delta N value is how much? 2 plus 1. First we have to consider products. Products minus reactants. That means 2 plus 1 minus 2. That means 3 minus 2. Total 1 value. That means delta N value positive value. So automatically delta H value is greater than delta E. Similarly in this case also same. If you find delta N value, you can find the relation between delta H and delta E. See, if you see this reaction, see in this case, this is present in solid state, but these two are present in gaseous state. Then delta N is what? 1 plus 1. Sorry, this is also present in solid state. Sorry, this is not gaseous state. This is present in solid state. Then 1 minus 0. 1. That means delta N value is positive. Then delta H greater than delta E. Here, oxygen is present in gaseous state. We know that. This is present in liquid state. So what is the value of NP? Only we have to consider this one. 1 minus 1 plus 2 total 3. 1 minus 3 nothing but minus 2. So that means delta N value negative. Automatically delta H will be less than delta E. That is very simple topic and a very very important topic. Next important concept here is first law of thermodynamics. This is also one of the important topic. Here the statement is, energy is neither created nor destroyed, but it can transfer from one form to another form. We know that this statement very well. This is also called law of conservation of energy. We cannot create energy and we cannot produce energy, but it can transfer from one form to another form. Here one more statement is there, that is, it is impossible to construct perpetual mission means which works without consuming energy. Can any mission works like that without consuming energy? Suppose take water pump, water motor. If you switch on the motor, then water comes from lower energy lower level to higher level in buildings, in houses. That means what it is doing in that case, water absorbing electrical energy, then automatically it converts mechanical energy. Their motor is working by taking electrical energy, then only water is coming from lower level to higher level. We have such type of machines only in the universe. We cannot have machines which works without consuming energy. That type of missions are called perpetual missions. What? That is one more statement. That means it is impossible to construct such type of missions. That means it is impossible to construct a missions which works without consuming energy. That means energy, we cannot create a mission. We cannot create a mission which produce energy without taking energy. Which produce energy without taking energy. That is the meaning of this point. That is also one of the statement. Here one more statement is this. That is what? Here energy transfer from one form to another form. Nothing but energy transfer from system to surroundings or from surrounding to system. We can say one more point from that statement. That is what? Total energy of the universe remains constant. That's it. Total energy of the universe remains constant. That is also one of the statement of first law of thermodynamics. Next, one more point. According to this law, heat supplied to the system means anything which is under observation, is equal to sum of change in internal energy and work done by the system. This is important point. Heat supplied to the system, that means Q is equal to sum of change in internal energy and work done by the system. That means minus W. From this delta E equal to what? Q plus W. This is very 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 important expression. Change in internal energy is equal to heat supplied to the system plus work done. This is what? First law of thermodynamic expression. This is very very important expression. Next, from this expression some IUPAC conventions are there. We have to know those conventions also. We know that work done by the system is what? Minus W. Work done on the system plus W. We have seen already these points in previous video. Here some more points are there like that. That is heat released by the system. That means system loses
heat minus U. Heat absorbed by the system, that means system gains heat, nothing but energy, so plus Q, like work. From that we can write delta E equal to minus Q minus W, minus Q plus W, plus Q minus W, plus Q plus W. These are IUPAC conventions, IUPAC notations. When this expression will obtain? When system loses heat and work done by the system. When this expression we get? When system loses heat and work done on the system. This one obtain when? When system gains heat and work done by the system. This one, system gains heat and work done on the system. These are the applications of the first law of thermodynamics. But what is the expression regarding first law of thermodynamics? Delta E equal to what? Q plus W. Here some more points are there regarding this one. The Q value for isothermal process. In isothermal process, delta T 0, delta E 0. Then work done by the system is what? Whether it is reversible or irreversible is equal to what? Q equal to minus W. How can we say that? Delta E equal to Q plus W. Delta E equal to Q plus W. In isothermal process, this will be 0. Automatically, W equal to what? Minus Q. Whether it is reversible or irreversible. Next, some problems are there based on this one. A system absorbs 600 joules of heat and it does work 400 joules. That means it absorbs 600 joules of heat. That means plus Q. And work for 400 joules. Does work means work done by the system. We have to take this expression delta equal to plus Q minus W. Then we get this value. So one more problem like that. That is, in a process, 701 joules of heat is absorbed by the system and it does work 394 joules. That means it absorbs this much amount of heat and it works this much amount of work. So again, same expression. Heat absorbed, that means plus Q. Work is done by the system, that means minus W. Then we get this one. Next, one more problem is there, like regarding this one. See, calculate number of kilojoules of heat necessary to raise a temperature of 60 grams of aluminium from 35 grams to 55 grams. 35 degrees to 55 degrees centigrade. Molar heat capacity of aluminium, that means molar heat capacity is given already. Molar heat capacity means what? One mole substance, that means 27 grams of aluminium. That means that energy is required, or the heat is required to convert 27 grams of aluminium temperature to 1 degree Celsius. That is called molar heat capacity. That is also given. We have to find what? Which one? Q value, that means heat. Before first law of thermodynamics, I discussed one point, that is what? Q is equal to C into delta T. And heat is applied to the system, that is proportional to mass and rise in temperature. From that expression, we get Q equal to C into delta T. That is for one mole. For n moles, we can write Q equal to N into C into delta T, where delta T is what? Rise in temperature. C is what? Molar heat capacity. N is what? Number of moles. Q is what? Heat supplied to the system. Number of moles formula is what? Weight by gram molecular weight. Weight is so much? 60 by gram molecular weight. Here molecule is not there, atom. So we can consider atomic weight into molar heat capacity, how much? 24. Into delta T, that means rise in temperature, nothing but difference in temperature. 55 minus 35, how much? 20. Then we get this value. Like that you can calculate.